I keep telling you guys that this is the funniest timeline, and every time I'm surprised even more at what happens the day after. Remember all the months before the release of the Joker movie and how the mainstream media smeared the movie? They said it will inspire incels and white supremacists to commit acts of violence on behalf of this movie. So far, zero of them actually happened, and the movie became the most successful R-rated movie in history. Now I want you guys to ruminate on the headline that I'm about to read and try to keep yourself from bursting into laughter. Birmingham City. 13-year-old girl among arrests after machete brawl during Frozen 2 viewing. Now first things first, Birmingham is in England where they ban knives. Machetes are some sort of a more dangerous knife, I guess, or a scimitar type sword, so I assume that's illegal there as well. A 13-year-old girl is among five teenagers arrested over a mass brawl involving youths armed with machetes at the Birmingham cinema. I want you guys to notice the plural form of machetes because there were actually more than one machete. There were two machetes and a knife recovered at the end of this brawl at the viewing of Frozen 2. I guess some girl just couldn't let it go. I want you guys to keep that in mind, that Frozen 2, a Disney movie for kids, had more violent acts committed in their viewings than The Joker, the R-rated film. What kind of clown-world shit is this? Someone had just changed the simulation settings to completely ridiculous. Now, I actually watched The Joker, and while I don't enjoy the DC universe except for Wonder Woman because Gal Gadot is a fucking goddess, I still appreciate the great acting in this movie and can recognize it should get an easy Oscar. What really irks me about the whole Joker situation is that the media response to Joker shows one or two things about the state of press right now. Either they are too stupid or too lazy. Why are they too stupid? Because the Joker is probably the most digestible, left-leaning, woke movie out there right now. The cast is diverse. The movie has a very anti-class message and shows what happens when mental health care is not funded enough by the government. The media that called this movie alt-right propaganda is either too stupid to understand what the movie stood for and how it criticized capitalism, or they are just too lazy to watch the movie and parroted the same points from their other journal friends who were either too lazy again or too stupid as well. There's not a single right-wing stance in the movie, so the reason the press went after it is beyond me. The only explanation is that it will shine a light on a man being pushed to the edge, making us question what led a guy into shooting up a place rather than blaming it on guns. That's it guys, I'm gonna go for now. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to drop a like and share it. And if you're new, make sure to subscribe and turn on the notification bell. I'll see you in the next video. Peace.